Huh. I've been waiting here a while.
I didn't think that you'd be here on time.
How was the meeting?
You knew about the meeting.
I am not getting into that.
Everyone's on your side. She's even on your side.
That kind of makes me feel worse.
Let's go and talk about this more.
It won't change my mind.
I think we should just forget about this. Move on.
I have been wounded, aching heart full of pain.
Still I rise, yes, still I rise.
Just like a budding rose, my bloom is nourished by rain.
Still I rise, yes, still I rise.
Haven't time to wonder why the fearful I strive.
Still I rise, yes, still I rise.
My prayer and faith uphold me till my courage arrives.
Still I rise, yes, still I rise.
Still I rise.
To see, maybe I could just stay like this on the precipice.
Can't go back and can't stand still and can't go on until all I know is I can't stay halfway.
John Harper comes out of the halfway house. He sees Lucas. Lucas sees him.
You!
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And as soon as we saw Matthew, it was very obvious that his care was beyond our capabilities. Called the neurosurgeon at Poudre Valley, and he was on the road in an hour and 15 minutes, I think.
I saw a picture. Days later, they showed me a picture of Matthew. I would have never recognized him.
Then 2 days later, I found out the connection, and I was very struck. They were two kids. They were both my patients, and they were two kids. I took care of both of them, of both of their bodies. And for a brief moment, I wondered if this is how God feels when he looks down at us. How we are all his kids. Our bodies, our souls. And I felt a great deal of compassion for both of them.
In Maine, they just changed that.
Welcome to Maine.
So, you can do that now.
I mean, I don't live in this.
Yeah, she's like, that's cool for that.
Life just moved too fast, life just moved too fast. You hit the moon and you never came back. Can you spend the time to relax? Life just not so clear, there's a foggy glass. Negatives that I can never look past, but yet I end up attached.
Yo, y'all are so warm.
Oh, hello! It's love. Look, I ripped both my pants buckles. It's like, oh, so when we FaceTime you, like talking to some chick, you're like, yo,
holy
like
fuck,
FaceTime.
While
you,
he's grabbing his leg, you, I don't
know. No, I have a fucking Android, bro.
Oh
like,
my
I can't
god,
FaceTime
yeah, that
you.
Was really your life.
Dude,
there's so many girls that I lost opportunities on because they're like,
Android.
They're like, oh, like let's FaceTime.
That's
I'm like,
crazy.
You got Snapchat? Like, yeah.
That's type of folks that I really despise. Money to apple, then I split the pie. Industry kills me, I'll go for a ride. First they be chirping, they know that I'm fly. First they be chirping, they know that I'm fly.
I was like, no offense, y'all. That sounds like it wasn't you. I was like, I was going to the that's why I did that. You can't hold me to it. You can't hold me to it.
We're stopping at New Morning.
Having a med card is one of the very few reasons as to why I'm still here. Because the weed's really good here, but like, not if you're trying to make out with your faces. So, if you're trying to lounge, then like, it's a good place to be.
Yeah.
You're trying to chill?
Yeah, yeah.
Alright. Go out! Go out with the blades of glory, bro. Go for it. See? Like, if I was gonna die.
Thank you. No matter where I go.
No matter where I go.
No matter where I go.
Everyone looks at me.
No matter where I go.
I go. And I'm always watched.
No.
I am always scrutinized, so.
Watched.
No matter what.
No matter why.
No matter where I go.
Eyes hear me first.
And inside rarely.
I walk around and move around.
Here.
They do not want to.
See me.
See more.
They do not want to hear me.
Hear more.
They do not want to look inside.
No more.
Would rather I become invisible.
Run and hide.
Time.
It takes.
Time. It breaks.
Away.
I try my best, but.
This time.
No more.
Eyes hear me first, but inside rarely.
Stepping through this beautiful, lovely, unjust world. My footsteps larger than what I think. Laugh to keep my feet from bruising. Tears to heal my tired, unrested feet. I will not rest until it is all behind me. I will not tread lightly anymore because I am more than just your silly boxes.
Like Katrina, without the water, watching helpless, made hapless, waiting. Waiting for rescue. Relief, the good guys, to ride in on white horses, not those with white hoods spewing hatred and grime, but rather those to make it right, just in the nick of time. Honor our humanity, stop the insanity, and save the day.
There have been too many days that end this way. Contempt on the loose, another chalk-lined body bag, black men down, lynching. Lynching is still lynching. They've just traded the cop's bullet for the lynchers' noose.
Pathologized, ostracized, marginalized, and terrorized time and time again. And for some of us, no relief comes. Institutionalized oppression, assault turned insult, then another, and another, and another in the action frame or virtual video game of living life all too real.
Till the populace is made to forget, and the population is made to go in again, and we return to the usual order of things again.
Discounting what we feel, born black and unequal in America.
This be slavery's legacy, part two, the sequel. Grotesque scenes played out before us to control the people. This is nonsense. Violence both to us and by us.
With booming bass and urban cities surround sound from pleading breath.
Hands up! Don't shoot! I can't breathe.
To bleeding.
Silence!
Please, don't kill me.
Here, the death scenes are real, where hate is allowed to surface free and surprisingly PC, political correctness. Scratch that. Retro reconstruction.
This is not just innocent nostalgia.
Let's be clear. They are trying to take their America back, one black man shot in the back at a time.
And the crime we're left with? Faux freedom? Rehashed racism? In this nouveau Jim Crow Jane Crow remix, this is what it feels like, right? Right, Richard? To slip back into white noise made the invisible. Man, woman, children, black, brown, native, colored, othered.
In their eyes, not worthy of respect, yet warranting as epitaph, a hashtag after they've come to collect the body and laid it to rest.
And we can't get mad, mourn, grieve. It seems because they just won't leave us alone.
But for the grace of God, there go I.
Mankind's queen.
The black man, the king's king, and yet people who can do these devilish things out of malice and hatred and disrespect.
Ah, but it ain't over yet, lest we forget. We can still build community. Dare to use our intellect, learn, connect, struggle on.
We must continue the struggle, defy injustice, resist the constraints that mind bind us, work till it's won.
Until the very last black man standing, if we must.
When did unity get to be a dirty word? When will we reap what our ancestors earned? When will we stand up, speak up, and be heard? I say, with justice, there is peace.
Father, Father, we don't need to escalate.
Oh,
war is not the answer.
Mm-hmm. Only love
can conquer hate. Mm. You know we've got to find a way.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
The what?
To bring some love in here today. Pick your signs. Pick your signs. Don't punish me with brutality. Ooh. Talk to me so you can see what's going on.
What's going on?
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 I got another one.
Sometimes I feel a little crazy when I say losing my feet has a good side to it. I mean, sure, prosthetics can be uncomfortable, but in a strange way, I feel like I've been freed from my past self. Not being so critical of myself and finally being able to look at myself and love what I see. 13-year-old me would be proud, finally accepting who I am.
Thank you. nobody? Who are you? Are you nobody too?
Scene 15, the living room. Next day, early evening. Buck is laying down on the floor. The cat comes in with a chicken bone in her mouth. She sits right by Buck, putting it just within his reach.
Chicken bone. Still has meat on it.
Where'd you get it?
The kitchen.
Yeah, I was in the kitchen once.
Duh.
She bats it closer to him. He doesn't go for it.
Don't you want it?
No.
But it still has meat on it.
Okay.
What's wrong with you? You got the good part of the chicken.
Yeah.
And peas?
Yeah.
And Lego?
Oh, that's what that was.
A car pulls into the driveway.
You're gonna get in trouble.
I'm always in trouble.
That's because you always get caught.
Oh, yeah.
Buck? Buck? Buck!
Ow!
What's wrong with you?
Sick.
Almost as though being forced by something larger than herself, Marie Antoinette starts licking him. She's slightly horrified she's doing it, but is compelled.
What are you doing?
I have no idea.
Feels good.
I didn't mean what I said before about hoping you would eat a poisonous Lego and die.
What?
Nothing. Never mind. Go to sleep. It's okay. I got you.
She resumes her licking, very gently. Gabby comes in the door quietly. When her mom comes through the door, she motions her to be quiet.
Buck. Marie Antoinette's kissing Buck.
Jesus, vomit on the floor!
Mabel goes to the kitchen.
Mom? Where's Mom?
He only sees the vomit. Play practice. Tomorrow night, basement. In front of the dryers.
Buck groans. Tommy looks at him, then beelines for Mabel's purse and wallet. Mabel walks in with paper towels to clean the mess.
Is this all you got?
Hey, what do you think you're doing? No,
I need to get a garbage can with a lid, or else one of these days Buck's just gonna die.
Put that back. The lid is down in the basement somewhere.
No, it's not. It hasn't been down there for like a year.
Don't you use that tone with me.
Look at him, Mom. Someone has to be the adult around here.
Takes her car keys out of her purse.
Hey, no one said you can go anywhere. Who do you...
No, they didn't.
That is $100 bill, young man.
Yes, Mabel, it is.
Thomas! Thomas, hey!
He's out the door. We hear the car start.
I want the change. Ah! Gabby! Damn it, you scared the shit out of me.
I'm surprised you have any shit left.
Scene 16, in the kitchen, shortly after. Brian is home. Tommy walks in with a chrome garbage can, the fancy cylindrical kind. He gets busy placing it, removing the stickers, etc.
What's that?
Garbage can?
I know that. Where'd you get it?
24-hour market.
When?
Just now.
Did your mom tell you to?
Nope.
Where'd you get the money?
Mom.
How much was it?
$89.50.
What? Jesus! Jesus!
Here's change.
$100? She gave you $100?
It has a lifetime warranty, like for life.
May, could you come here?
What was I supposed to do? Someone had to do something, Dad. You can't just keep hoping someone's going to change. You got to just accept who they are. And Buck is a garbage eater. He always was, and he always will be. And if you don't want him to do what he does, then you get a garbage can that doesn't let him.
Brian, I think Buck's really sick.
Did you say he could spend $100 on a garbage can?
No, I didn't, but I think Tommy's right. We need to take him to the vet.
I'll get a blanket for the car.
Hey, I was asking a question here.
Our vet's not open until the morning, but
I gave him Pepto-Bismol. He'll be fine.
There's a 24-hour animal, big animal place in Hillsdale.
Right?
Hillsdale? Do you know how far that is?
Plansky took his cat there. No, it's far really good.
Expensive. Very. But it's the only place.
It's open. Insanely expensive.
I mean, the cat died, but he said they were good.
Let me go check on Buck.
I'll go get the emergency credit card.
Wait, what? No, you won't.
What?
That's for emergencies. You don't just decide that it's okay to use that without asking me.
Okay, so I'll ask you.
Yeah, but you didn't.
What's happening?
There was a statue here, a soldier, a wise man with a sword. There was a statue here, a soldier, a statue of a wise man.
Voices falter, voices crack, but if you're beautiful, it makes up for what you lack. My body... To each her own, to each her own. I adore your cream of mushroom.
I admire your velvet tone.
To each her own. Tapestry's richer by a drop in the sea. Now that 38 indent marks has me.
So squash your joy like some annoying gnat. Hang your heart in darkness like a bat. Misery and pain, that's where it's at. In other words, it's really black and white.
Play-Doh Mold and Mash comes with everything you see here. Sparkling six-pack sold separately.
So glum. This party is so boring.
Yeah, Brainy, this is so lame.
And we don't have anything cool to drink. I have just the thing. Fairy Brain Blast with vitamin C.
Wow!
Brainy, this is really good. I know. And it comes with vengeance in every pack. Yeah!
Wait, what'd you say?
That sure hits the spot, Brainy.
Mm-hmm. Drink up, Maddie.
Matt, I wouldn't drink that if I were you.
Maddie boy over there decided to drink another juice behind my back. That will show him not to fuck with me, Liz.
Brainy, you just can't murder people!
Do we have an issue, bitch?
No.
Nuh-uh. I'm more than happy to call the police.
You'll never get away with this.
What are you gonna say? A cartoon mascot murdered your friend? Ha! Good luck.
What to do? The outlook was decidedly blue. But as I walk through the foggy streets alone, it turned out to be the luckiest day. A foggy day in London.
last thing last. But the age of miracles, it hadn't passed. For suddenly I saw you there, and through foggy London town, the sun was shining everywhere.
Call my wife, mistress, and she will call you, gallant. Let him be a little familiar. You often want one to make up your card table, and gamblers may be rude to ladies, you know.
Yes, losing gamblers have a privilege with women.
I always thought winning gamblers had the most privilege, for when you have lost your money to a man, he may use you as he pleases.
If he behaves himself, I'll give him freedom.
All sorts of freedom, madam?
Yes, all sorts of freedom. Go and be better acquainted.
I think I know her already, and may venture my secret for hers.
Sister, cousin, you see, I have provided an innocent playfellow for you.
We'll have no such playfellows.
No, you won't choose playfellows for us. Thank you.
Could you be so generous that for the sake of us women, you would call yourself no man while you are still perfectly, perfectly the same man as before going to France?
As perfectly, perfectly, madam, do not take my word for it.
Generally, you men report such things of yourself, one does not know who to believe.
I desire to be tried only.
Spoken like a man of honor.
All men of honor desire to come to the test.
You may do your worst, dear, dear sir.
Is your ladyship reconciled to him? Have you agreed on matters?
Indeed we have, Sir Jasper. Cousin Squeamish, Sister Dainty, you know that not long ago I thought Master Horner's very name was an obscenity. I would have soon have lain with him as named him, but Master Horner is 1,000 times a better man than I thought.
I believe you.
No doubt on it.
Well then, now you may go to your business together. Your business, which is pleasure. while I go to my pleasure. Business?
Come then, dear gallant.
Come away, my dearest mistress.
Just as I'd have it.
And as I'd have it.
He who for his business from his wife will run.
Takes the best care.
To have her business done.
Oh. I've been toiling and moiling for the prettiest piece of china.
She has been too hard for me. Do what I could.
I'll have some china also, Mr. Horner.
That's right. Don't think you can give other people china and me none. Come in with me too.
Upon my honor, I have none left.
I've known you to deny your china before, but you won't put me off.
Or me.
This lady got the last there.
Yes, to my certain knowledge, he has no more left.
Oh, but he may have some you could not find.
Do you think if he had any left, I would not have had it too? Some women of quality never have china enough.
I cannot make china for you all right now, but I will have some for you too, another time.
What do you mean by that promise?
They have an innocent, literal understanding.
Mr. Horner has enough to do to please you all, I see.
Come, beast, dine with us, for we'll want a man at cards after dinner.
That's all their use of me.
Come, beast.
I'll lead, to be sure of you.
Oh, poor gentlemen, how they tug at you. Kiss them.
You know I would suffer anything but that.
Oh, kiss. That's the only way to keep nice women quiet.
Well, nothing else could bribe me.
Mwah. Oh, you filthy toad.
Oh, no, I'm done jesting.
So, a piece of his.
I told you so.
Horner!
A man, Sir Jasper, I would not be seen here for the world.
But I am here with you.
No, my honor.
Oh, let us be gone.
Howist, Sparks, howist?
Sparkus, a rogue who is fond of me only for abusing him.
And it is very hard to get rid of him.
Well, Harry, I must mock you a little. Upon the reports in town of you.
Being in the company of men of sense, he thinks he can pass for one.
But to pass for a wit, he shows himself a fool.
I can't hold. I must speak. I was discoursing with some ladies yesterday about the fine new signs in town. I said, I know where the best new sign is.
Where?
Says one of the ladies. In Russell Street, answered I. Lord, says another, I'm sure there was no fine new sign there yesterday. Yes, answered I, and it came out of France, and has been there a fortnight.
I can hear no more.
Hold, I will make you laugh. It cannot be, says a third lady. Yes, said I, says a fourth lady.
We'll have no more ladies,
said I. Did you never see Mr. Horner? He lodges in Russell Street, and he's a sign of a man, you know, since he came out of France. And then they all fell out laughing till they pissed themselves.
And that is a sign of a jest.
Pshaw! Does it not move you? Well, come, Sparks, where do we dine? I have left an earl to dine with you.
Go, dine with your earl.
We will not mind.
Do you think I'll eat with shallow fops? No. Wit is the greatest title in the world. Wit is as necessary at dinner as good wine. And that's the reason I never have any stomach when I eat alone. Well, come, Sparks, where do we dine?
Oh, please, no means, go,
sir. Pshaw! With all this fooling, we'll miss the new play. And I never miss seeing a new play the first day. Never mind, I'll fetch my mistress instead.
You have a mistress?
Pshaw!
Oh,
Thank you. Hello, and welcome to New Voices. Please sit back and enjoy Untitled and New Voices 2020.
Hello, Evelyn and Elia. My apologies, I was running a little late. You must be Yesenia.
Yes, and you're Miss Naval.
Mommy, it's Novak.
Ay, Dios mío. Lo siento.
Está bien. Sucede todo el tiempo.
So, how does all of this work?
Well, you're already in the removal process. And that means that ICE is trying to get an immigration judge to give permission to deport you back to your home country.
I can't go back to Honduras. It's very dangerous. There's a lot of gangs there, and I think...
Were you ever targeted by one of these gangs?
Sí. That's why I left.
We can tell that to the judge. You have what we call an asylum case.
What does that mean?
It just means someone suffered from harm or fears harm in their country of origin due to a number of reasons, like race, religion, political opinion, your membership to a certain group, etc. Basically, it's for those who fear persecution. However, you have to apply for asylum within a year of coming to the U.S. I don't want to assume, but I'm assuming you didn't do that?
No, yo no sabía.
That's okay. Nosotros podemos hablar con el juez.
Could she still apply for asylum while in the country?
Yes, she can. But it will be tricky. I won't lie.
And if she doesn't get approved, then what?
Well, if the judge does sign the removal papers, then she will be deported.
Mommy, we're not going to let that happen.
I know, mijo. I know.
You see, Mommy, we could have a chance.
I see, mija, pero si me quedo aquí... Ellos verán cada uno de mis movimientos y eso es lo mismo que ser deportado.
Pero mami, si te deportan, no puedes estar con nosotros.
Sí. Y eso es todo lo que me importa.
Well, I'll give you all the guys this time to talk before we have to go into court.
Gracias, señora Novak.
De nada. Sus niños son valientes y fuertes.
Lo sé.
Novak begins to walk off stage.
Ms. Novak?
Yes.
Do you really think we could win this?
I have strong faith that we could, yes. Why? Are you nervous?
Yeah. Both Adele and I are. He likes to pretend that he isn't scared, but sometimes I hear him cry at night, but don't tell him that I told you. He will make me eat cold mac and cheese forever if he finds out.
Don't worry. It's our little secret.
I just want everything to go back to normal.
I know the feeling.
And if we don't win, then it would never be normal and all of this wouldn't be worth it.
But it would be worth it, Elia, whether you win it or not.
How could it be worth it if she gets deported?
Because you spoke up. You did something that most kids your age would be afraid to do. You're fighting back against the system. And that, to me, that's the most important thing. Letting people know when they're wrong and putting them in their place, and that's what you're doing. Don't ever think of this as not worth it.
My mommy doesn't think it's worth it.
Sometimes it's a little harder for people to realize that when people have put them down for so long. But trust me, she does think it's worth it.
Do you have kids?
I do. I have three.
What would you want them to do in this situation?
Exactly what you and Adele are doing. Now you should get back and talk to your mommy. This could be the last time you get to do that before the court date.
Thank you, Ms. Novak.
Of course.
Wonderful.
Is it satisfying at night? Does it make you want to go any direction?
But it's fine.
Or does it make you want to go any direction?
I don't
I'm being a little to the right, but it's okay.
Why bubbles? Like, why don't we do like?
Because I have a fireplace.
I think it is definitely not like that one.
Something's off. They don't have lights.
I don't know how to turn that. So this is what we're going with.
Okay, so what is this creature?
So this creature doesn't have a name. He moves across like surfaces, you know, just like walking. You know, he has these like little legs. But he does climb on things, inchworm style. You know, creepy crawler kind of. He can, you know, walk up stuff. So his antenna are like glowy, and they're not like lights, but you know, they emit light, but they're not like actually lights, because you know, he's a little bug, but they glow. So it's this creature that I always see right before I have like lucid dreams or reoccurring dreams, little like maybe like signifying or like guiding character, you know, and like lets me know, like, oh, you're about to have a weird dream, or like, hey, heads up, you're about to have a lucid dream. Like, don't, you know, freak out too much. You're in control. You're good. but yeah, so not always these colors, but I chose these colors. Definitely changes colors depending on, like, the scenery of the dream. You know, the mood of the dream. The weather of the dream. A lot of my dreams are outside.
So this little guy was originally something that I drew when I was in Ireland, and I drew like a series of animals with food spilled on their heads because I thought it was funny. And when we were in Ireland, we like went on a bunch of group dinners, and one of the group dinners was this Italian restaurant that was like pretty subpar, to be honest. But this little sheep guy, you know, he's like probably on a Italian farmer's farm in Italy, you know, but he's a sheep, so he somehow got on a boat and made it from Ireland to Italy. But I mean, maybe there's sheep in Italy. I don't know. I've never been to Italy, but I've been to Ireland, and I could tell you there is a fuck ton of sheep. So many sheep, man. Symbol thing. But this little guy kind of does little leaps, and I kind of imagine him in like a field or a meadow, and he's just happily like skipping along, leaving a trail of spaghetti meatballs, you know, on top of spaghetti, all covered in cheese. There was a sheep with meatballs and nudes.
All right, come here.
Yes.
Can you tell me about your guy?
Yeah, this is my guy. He's pretty cool. He's kind of like a bird. He has like, kind of like a beak type thing. Mm-hmm. It's pretty cool. His legs are very bouncy, right? So when he walks, he bounces. Kind of like he just kind of like hops along rhythmically. Just like that.
Okay.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And his legs just kind of bounce along, and his knees just like pop out. Kind of cool. I like him. I drew him before, and I really just wanted to see what he would look like walking around. You know, his previous idea. I'm very excited.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Can you give me like things he might be doing?
Things he might be doing? He just kind of walks along. You know. Just kind of paces back and
y'all
forth.
Y'all are horrible descriptions. Both Dude. Of you are just like, he walks.
He walks along. But he like, bounces.
A place he might be going.
I was just going to say just on the sidewalk.
You're
hard-blooded. No. Okay, where do you want me to put him? Like in the middle of like, I don't know, a volcano?
Where is it specifically?
So, okay. You're crunching over all of my audio. Okay, so this guy's small, right? Mm-hmm. Like, really tiny. So if I was just seeing this guy on a casual, like, day, if you were drinking, like, coffee out of a mug, he'd just, like, appear behind the mug and, like, walk around. And you're just, like, poof, and then just start walking around.
Like, this big to this big?
Yes.
Are we passing these around?
No, it's just yours.
Sick. No.
I don't know how much more detail I want to add. I know we need to color. I don't know how much more pencil. I think like inchworm, but caterpillar.
I don't know how he walks, so like I'm interested to see how you think he walks.
Oh, it's like a spring.
Is it? Like, I don't think it's gonna be like a bounce. It might be. I was thinking that his knees just like kick out.
Like, I think I'm almost.
Yeah, it's okay. I'm kind of.
How close are you guys? Hannah hasn't done any color yet.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, I'm pretty much done. I'm
just having fun adding some extra ones. I'm almost done. Oh shit, wait, I saw the color, don't I?
Yeah, I'm so.
Oh.